La lista ya está hecha ahí atrás. Secret Sisters, vamos a tener nuestro amigo secreto. Sign up sheet is also in the back. Si usted quiere participar, puede firmar, está atrás también la página. If you do not sign up by next Sunday, si usted no ha firmado para el próximo domingo, sorry.
Like Brother Star. There is no one higher than you. call you got an answer.
Pero esta es la iglesia de Señor.
y ponemos aceite en su cabeza.
And the oil is just an instrument.
Pero el aceite es simplemente un instrumento.
We obey the word of God.
Que obedecemos la palabra de Dios.
But when we mention the name of the Lord,
pero cuando nosotros mencionamos el nombre del Señor,
something happens in that moment.
Algo pasa en ese momento.
Heaven opened the doors.
Los cielos son abiertos.
Miracles start pouring on.
Yes.
Los milagros comienzan a ser derramados sobre su iglesia.
It's not our hands.
No es nuestras manos.
It's not our pastor.
No es nuestro pastor.
It's not my hands.
No es mi mano.
It's not how I could have talked.
No es cuán bueno yo hable.
It's not how good I can express by my own words.
No es tan, no es cuán bueno yo pueda expresarme con mis propias palabras.
In the name of Jesus. How God talked about John. Jesus' heart.
Juan sentía el corazón del Señor.
How Jesus' heart beat.
Cómo palpitaba el corazón del Señor.
It was not like your heart or my heart.
No era como su corazón o el mío.
Every time.
Cada vez.
Every beat.
Y cada palpitar.
Was soul.
Decía almas.
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 So John can feel that.
Así que Juan podía sentir esto.
And that's the same feeling.
Este es el mismo sentir.
The church has to be part of that.
Que la iglesia debe ser parte.
And when we go to the book of Acts,
cuando vamos al libro de los Hechos,
we know they start the church in homes.
Vemos que la iglesia comenzó en las casas.
So if you want to be a real apostolic church,
si usted quiere que seamos una real iglesia apostólica,
be part of the groups.
Debemos de ser parte de los grupos.
Be part of this biblical.
Debemos de ser parte de esto bíblico.
We're gonna start probably next month.
Vamos.
Es
posible que vamos a comenzar una vez más en enero.
It's not because we are super ready for that.
Estamos bien listos para esto.
Sister Selena asks me this almost every week.
Nuestra hermana Selena me pregunta esto casi todas las semanas.
But we have to follow some rules.
Debemos de seguir algunas reglas.
So we not put out. Our soul groups apart.
No es que hemos puesto a nuestros grupos a un lado.
We are just waiting to the right time.
Es simplemente que estamos esperando el momento correcto.
So, ready.
Estamos listos.
Ready.
Y esté listo.
Everybody say Friday.
Friday.
Diga viernes.
Everybody say Friday.
Friday.
Okay. Look. Let me ask you something. Who loves our church?
¿Quién ama la iglesia?
People.
¿Cuándo usted siente que es el tiempo?
To be baptized in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ.
De ser bautizado en el precioso nombre de Jesús.
The Bible says.
La Biblia dice.
Suddenly.
De repente.
Instantly.
Instantáneamente.
The man said, "There's water. What hinders?"
Hay algo que impide.
Baptize me.
Bautízame.
It's very important.
Es muy importante.
As a plan of salvation.
Del plan de salvación.
Brother Star taught it this morning.
En nuestro hermano Star enseñó esta mañana.
We have to be born of the water and the Spirit.
Debemos hacer del agua y del Espíritu.
Amen. So we're going to have a baptism.
Que vamos a tener un bautismo.
And I promise you, I won't preach long.
Y le prometo que no voy a predicar largo.
The Spirit of God has already moved.
El Espíritu de Dios ya se ha movido.
We've already felt the presence of the Lord.
Hemos sentido la presencia de Dios.
What better way?
Una mejor manera.
To interrupt the service.
¿Qué mejor manera de interrumpir el servicio?
Than to have a baptism.
Y tener un bautismo.
Amen. Now I can say this.
Ahora puedo decir esto.
Aren't you glad that our baptism is up and running? It took many hands.
Es parte de muchas manos.
And many dollars.
Y muchos mucho dinero.
But it's working and we're thankful for it.
Pero está trabajando el bautisterio. Amen. Gracias a Dios.
We're thankful for hot water.
Gracias a Dios. Hay agua caliente.
Amen. You may be seated.
Puede tomar asiento.
You know, Jeremiah.
Jeremías.
He was asking the Lord.
He said, "How do I verify that I have your word?"
¿Cómo puedo verificar de que yo tengo tu palabra?
People are going to question me.
Las personas te van a interrogar o preguntar.
Whether or not I'm from God.
Si eres o vienes de Dios.
God said, "You tell them." God said, "You tell them this."
Y Dios le dijo, "Tú diles esto."
God said, "You tell them my word is a hammer."
Dile que mi palabra es como un martillo.
He said, "You tell them my word is fire."
Tú dile que mi palabra es fuego.
And he said, "You tell them my word is wheat."
Y dile que mi palabra es
Preston.
Trigo.
Can you get me the big Bible? The big Bible. God said, "My word is like a hammer."
Él dijo, "Mi palabra es como un martillo."
I have.
Yo tengo.
On my hands.
Tengo.
They're called cysts. Do you know that they use the word of God to heal these?
¿Sabe que yo ocupé la palabra de Dios para sanarme?
Back in the day before they had surgery,
antes de que yo tuviera cirugía,
before they could cut you open,
antes que te cortaran,
the doctor would make his rounds.
El doctor iba a hacer su
round. He would come to your house.
Él venía a tu casa.
He would. Can you believe that? The doctor came to your house.
¿Puede creer eso? El doctor venía a tu casa.
And we're advanced today, huh?
Estamos avanzados hoy.
He would come to your house.
Él venía a casa.
And he would say, he would examine you.
Él te examinaba.
And someone would say, "Oh, I got these bumps on my hand."
Y alguien decía, "Bueno, tengo esto en mi mano."
"Can you help me, doctor?"
¿Me puede ayudar, doctor?
The doctor would say, "Yes, I can."
Y el doctor decía, "Sí, claro que puedo."
"Do you have a Bible?"
¿Tienes una Biblia?
He said, "Can you go get it? Shake the dust off of it."
¿Puedes ir a cogerla, por favor, y quitarle el polvo?
"I'm going to show you how to do surgery."
Te voy a enseñar a hacer cirugía.
With the word of God.
Con la palabra de Dios.
Now, you couldn't bring him one of these. No, this is too small.
Esto era muy pequeño.
This is too flimsy.
Es muy suave.
You need the big Bible.
Tú necesitas una Biblia grande.
You know, sometimes we like to, when we pray, we like to shout.
Muchas veces cuando oramos nos gusta alzar nuestra voz.
Some things aren't always a quiet prayer.
Muchas veces hay oraciones que no son calladas.
Some things we have to get loud about.
Muchas veces tenemos que alzar nuestra voz.
Sometimes we whisper the name of Jesus.
Hay veces susurramos el nombre de Jesús.
But sometimes we shout the name of Jesus.
Pero muchas veces lo gritamos también.
Amen.
Amen.
Y'all know Brother Billy Cole?
¿Aquí conoce ese predicador?
He was a powerful man of God.
Él era un hombre poderoso en el Señor.
He seen miracles.
Él vio milagros.
Healings.
Sanidades.
Hundreds of thousands of people prayed through in the Holy Ghost.
Muchas personas reciben el Espíritu Santo.
And he said when he went to pray for somebody,
y cuando él fue a orar por alguien,
and nothing happened,
y nada pasó,
he would start to get louder.
Él comenzaba a subir su voz.
In Jesus' name!
Amen.
He said his dad told him, get loud.
Decía, sube tu voz.
Now I know God can hear you.
Yo sé que Dios te puede escuchar.
Someone's thinking that right now. God's not deaf.
Alguien dice, Dios no es sordo.
God can hear.
Dios puede escuchar.
That book getting heavy? Okay. But the doctor said, you got to go get the big Bible.
Pero el doctor decía, ve y toma la Biblia grande.
Because I'm going to show you how to heal with the word of God.
Te voy a enseñar cómo sanar con la palabra de Dios.
And these people are thinking, I've never heard it like this before.
Y estas personas decían, yo nunca he escuchado una cosa así.
Let's see what this doctor can do with the word of God.
Vamos a ver qué puede hacer este doctor con la palabra de Dios.
Someone would bring him the big Bible. They would bring him the big Bible.
Y traían las Biblias grandes.
And he would take that Bible.
Y cogía esa Biblia.
He would examine it.
La examinaba.
How heavy it is.
Miraba que cuán pesada era.
See how strong the cover.
Qué tan fuerte era la pasta.
Said, okay, this is going to work.
Okay, esto va a funcionar.
You've got a good one.
Tienes una buena.
Put your hand out.
Baja tu mano.
Just like this.
De esta manera.
Frank, come on over. That doctor would put your hand out. You trust me? Put your hand right here.
Pon tu mano ahí.
That doctor would take that word of God.
Ese doctor tomaba la palabra de Dios.
And he would look at that family.
Y miraba esa familia.
He would tell you to close your eyes.
Y le decía, cierra tus ojos.
And I'm going to show you how I can heal with the word of God.
Te voy a enseñar cómo puedo sanar con la palabra.
With all the strength he had,
con todas las fuerzas que él tenía,
he would lift that Bible up to the sky.
Levantaba esa Biblia hacia los cielos.
He would say, in Jesus' name,
decía, en el nombre de Jesús,
whack! And that cyst would disappear.
Y eso desaparecía.
God's word is like a hammer, folks.
La palabra de Dios es como un martillo.
You can get whacked with it.
Puedes ser,
you can get hit with it.
Te puede golpear.
It's like fire.
Es como fuego.
It will consume you.
Te consume.
Or it could be like wheat.
O puede ser como
the very nutrients that you need to live.
Tiene todo el nutriente que tú
necesitas.
It could
be the very food that you need.
Es la comida que tú necesitas, el alimento que tú necesitas.
Amen. You choose how the word of God.
Tú escoges cómo quieres que la palabra de Dios
is to you.
Se usa.
Okay, we're going to have this baptism.
This is a big step for Kelly today. Kelly,
paso para
today
Kelly
begins the rest of your life. We are praying for you that as you get baptized in Jesus' name, all your sins will be washed away, whatever you've ever done. Thank God for the blood. We're going to baptize you in Jesus' name. And God is going to move in your life. And I want everybody to raise your hand if you're going to pray for Kelly. You look. Kelly needs our prayers. The devil comes with a lot of opposition. But today we declare the victory in Jesus' name. Of your sins.
Praise God. Amen.
Gloria a Dios. Aleluya, Jesús.
Aleluya. Praise the Lord.
Gloria a Dios.
Amen. You may be seated.
Puede tomar asiento.
Amen. We're glad that we're able to do that today.
Estoy contento que pudimos hacer esto hoy.
Some of us need to remember when we got baptized.
Algunos debiéramos de recordar el primer día que
fuimos bautizados. How many had hot water? Hot water when you got baptized. Warm water.
Agua caliente cuando fui bautizado.
Not me. We were in the basement. In the basement.
En el sótano.
And there was a horse trough.
Y había una vida para los caballos.
Stainless steel, just a steel.
De aluminio.
And they filled that up with cold water.
Y llenaron eso con agua fría.
They didn't even ask you if you wanted warm water.
No te preguntaban si querías agua caliente.
Nobody thought to suggest it.
Nadie lo mencionaba.
You know, you didn't care. You didn't mind at all.
No te importaba.
You wanted to be baptized.
Tú simplemente querías ser bautizado.
And you didn't care what the water was like.
No te importaba cómo estuviese el agua.
Because God had done something to the inside.
Porque Dios había hecho algo adentro de mí.
And you felt the desire and the need to be baptized.
Y sentí el deseo de ser bautizado.
And you wanted to identify with Jesus.
Y quieres identificarte con el Señor.
In water baptism.
En el agua, en el bautismo en agua.
Well, I'm not going to preach today. All right, we'll try.
Vamos a tratar.
Stand for the reading of the Word of God.
Vamos a ponernos de pies para leer la palabra de Dios.
I'm always ready to say something.
Siempre estoy listo para decir algo.
I'm thankful each and every one of you are here this morning.
Estoy agradecido por cada uno de ustedes en esta mañana.
I truly love and appreciate.
Les amo y les aprecio.
This great church.
Esta iglesia maravillosa.
And each one of you make this church great.
Usted hace esta iglesia.
Jeremiah chapter 1, verse number 5.
En Jeremías 1:5.
The Bible says, Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee.
Antes que te formase en el vientre, te conocí.
And before thou comest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee.
Y antes que nacieses, te santifiqué, te di por profeta a las naciones.
And I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations.
Amen.
I want to preach today just for a little bit.
Quiero predicar un poco.
Famous last words.
Las palabras famosas.
Just a little bit on a subject entitled.
Bajo el título.
He loved me first.
Él me amó primero.
He loved me first.
Él me amó primero.
As you're sitting down, tell someone, he loved me first.
Dígale a alguien, a su vecino, él me amó primero. Mientras toma asiento.
Amen. You may be seated.
Puede tomar asiento.
There's something about those three words.
Hay algo en esas tres palabras.
The three words that we all want to hear.
Las tres palabras que todos queremos escuchar.
Those three words that sometimes are so hard to say.
Tres palabras que a veces nos es tan difícil decirlas.
I love you.
Te amo.
Sometimes it's difficult to say that.
Muchas veces es difícil decirlo.
But when you hear those three words,
pero cuando tú escuchas estas palabras,
I love you,
te amo,
it can melt your heart.
Puede hacer tu corazón derretir.
Or it can set you on fire with anger.
O te puede poner en fuego o enojo.
It's amazing how those three words,
es increíble como esas tres palabras,
they can mean everything to you.
Pueden significar todo para ti.
And at the same time,
y al mismo tiempo,
nothing.
Nada.
Depending on who says it.
Dependiendo de quién te las diga.
And why they're saying it.
¿Y por qué te las dicen?
Are they saying, I love you?
Te están diciendo, te amo.
Because they want something from you.
Porque quieren algo de ti.
For the 1800th time.
Por las 18 veces.
And their I love you starts to mean nothing to you.
Y muchas veces ese te amo no comienza a tener ningún valor para ti.
It might have meant something to you on the first try.
Probablemente significaba algo para ti en el principio.
But after so long, you start to not hear it anymore.
Pero después de un tiempo, ya no lo quieres escuchar.
I love you, three of the hardest words to say.
Te amo es una de las tres palabras más difícil de expresar.
When said properly,
cuando se dicen apropiadamente,
there are side effects.
Hay efectos secundarios.
Sometimes there's an absence in your stomach.
Muchas veces hay algo en tu estómago.
When my, I guess she was my girlfriend.
Cuando mi novia.
We weren't really dating.
No estábamos teniendo una relación.
When Sister Thomason first told me, I love you.
Cuando mi esposa me dijo por primera vez, te amo.
Well, I'd like to go back to that feeling again.
Yo quiero regresar a ese sentir.
Amen. How many would like to go back to that feeling again?
¿Cuántos les gustaría regresar a ese sentir?
The Bible talks about leaving your first love.
La Biblia habla de tu primer amor.
You have to get back to your first love.
Tienes que regresar a tu primer amor.
I'm talking about the Lord Jesus Christ.
Estoy hablando del Señor.
When you first fell in love with Him.
Cuando la primera vez te enamoraste de Él.
At an altar of repentance.
En un altar de arrepentimiento.
When you first fell in love with Him.
Cuando te enamoraste de Él.
When you went down in the water.
Cuando fuiste a las aguas.
In the name of Jesus
Christ.
En el
nombre de Jesús.
When you first felt His love.
Cuando sentiste por primera
vez su amor. When you first felt His passion for you.
Cuando sentiste su pasión para ti.
I love you.
Te amo.
It could bring silence.
Puede traer silencio.
You love me?
¿Tú me amas?
It could bring tears to your eyes.
Puede traer lágrimas.
But sometimes you never get tired of hearing.
Pero muchas veces no te vas a cansar de escucharlas.
Those three words.
Esas tres palabras.
I love you.
Te amo.
It could bring overwhelming joy.
Te puede traer gozo.
I can see it right now on everybody's face.
Yo puedo verlo en las
just talking about those three words.
Simplemente el hablar de esas palabras.
Are bringing smiles to
trae
everyone.
Una sonrisa.
And you're all thinking about the last time you told somebody.
Y piensas en la última vez que dijiste estas palabras a alguien.
I love you.
Te amo.
What power.
Qué poder.
What authority there is.
Qué autoridad hay en él.
In those three words.
En estas tres palabras.
I want you to remember today.
Quiero que usted recuerde hoy.
Every time you tell Jesus,
cada vez que tú le digas a Jesús,
I love you,
te amo,
He loved you first.
Él te amó primero.
Amen. I remember.
Yo me recuerdo.
A story told by a famous preacher.
Una historia de un famoso predicador.
He was preaching a camp meeting.
Él estaba predicando en el campamento.
And it was going great.
Estaba, había un mover maravilloso.
Everybody was worshiping.
Todos estaban adorando a Dios.
Everybody was speaking in tongues.
Todos hablaban en lenguas.
It was a success.
Era algo exitoso.
But he felt dead on the inside.
Pero él se sentía muerto por dentro.
He felt empty on the inside.
Él se sentía vacío por dentro.
It was the last night of the camp meeting.
Esto era el último día del campamento.
He told the Lord,
y él le dijo al Señor,
if I don't feel nothing on this camp meeting night,
Señor, si yo no siento nada en este campamento,
I quit.
Yo renuncio.
I'm not doing it anymore.
Yo no lo voy a hacer más.
During all those services,
durante todos los servicios,
there was a boy who got his attention.
Había un joven que captó su atención.
He was kind of the joke of the camp.
Él era como el chistoso del campamento.
He was wearing a white shirt.
Él estaba usando una camisa blanca.
It was way too big for him.
Era un poco grande para él.
It was dirty around the collar.
Estaba sucia en el cuello.
The sleeves were dirty.
Las mangas estaban sucias.
It wasn't tucked in properly.
No tenía su camisa por dentro.
And he was kind of the joke.
Y él era el que hacía los chistes.
But that's not what drew his attention to this boy.
Pero esto no fue lo que captó la atención de este niño, este joven.
At this particular camp meeting,
en este campamento en particular,
they had a light above the door.
Tenían una luz por encima de la puerta.
And when that light would blink red, It didn't matter how hot the service was.
No importaba qué tan en fuego estuviera el servicio.
Kids would be crying and praying and speaking in tongues.
Podían estar llorando y hablando en lenguas.
Running the aisles.
Corriendo en el altar.
Worshiping God.
Bendiciendo a Dios, alabando a Dios.
But when that light blinked red,
pero cuando esta luz se ponía en rojo,
it meant the concession stand was now open.
Quería decir que
the food was now available.
Quería dar a entender que la comida ya estaba lista.
They'd be running the aisles.
Estaban corriendo en el altar.
Like, come on, they'd run right out the door.
Veían la luz roja y salían corriendo hacia el comedor.
Crying and worshiping.
Llorando y alabando a Dios.
One eye open.
Con un ojo abierto.
As soon as the light blinked red.
En el momento que la luz se ponía en rojo.
Oh, it's time to eat.
Oh, es tiempo de comer.
Don't tell me you don't know what you're doing when you're praising God.
No me diga que usted no sabe qué está haciendo cuando está alabando a Dios.
Everybody but that joke, that one boy.
Todos vieron que ese joven,
he would still be there praying at the altar.
Este joven se mantuvo orando a Dios.
With his hands lifted up.
Con sus manos alzadas.
But his head down.
Con su cabeza para abajo.
He would be crying out, Jesus!
Él gritaba, Jesús.
I love you most of all, Jesus.
Te amo, Señor.
Over and over again.
Una y otra vez.
Everybody would leave.
Todos se habían ido.
And then finally, even the preacher would leave.
Y al final, aún el predicador se iba a ir.
On his way back.
En su camino para atrás.
After eating.
Después de comer.
He had to pass the sanctuary.
Él tenía que atravesar el santuario.
And he heard something in the sanctuary.
Y él escuchó algo en el santuario.
That same boy.
Ese mismo joven.
Praying at the altar.
Orando en el altar.
Crying out unto God.
Llorando a Dios.
Jesus, I love you most of all.
Señor, yo te amo sobre todas las cosas.
Day after day.
Día tras día.
Night after night.
Noche tras noche.
And now we're on the last night of the camp meeting.
Y ahora estamos en el último servicio del campamento.
And he made a deal with the Lord. The preacher made a deal with God.
Y este predicador hizo
made a bargain.
Acuerdo con él, con Dios.
If I don't feel you tonight,
si yo no te siento hoy en esta noche,
I'm done.
Termino, me voy.
He preached a good message.
Él predicó un buen mensaje.
The Holy Ghost fell.
Y el Espíritu Santo cayó.
He didn't feel
nothing. Y él no sintió nada.
He said, that's it, I'm done.
Y él dijo, hasta aquí.
I believe the Lord said something like this to him.
Y yo creo que Dios le dijo algo así a él.
I'll tell you.
Te voy a decir cuando te
digo. He said, that boy that everybody's laughing at,
ese joven del cual se están riendo,
he needs to pray for you.
Él necesita orar por ti.
You know what happened to that preacher?
¿Sabe lo que pasó con ese predicador?
He didn't go get prayed for.
Él no fue para que orara por él.
He said, you're not praying for me.
Él dijo, tú no vas a orar por mí.
I'm the camp meeting preacher.
Yo soy el predicador del campamento.
That's just a boy.
Esto es simplemente un joven.
That's a boy who's in touch with God.
Era un joven que estaba conectado con Dios.
That's a boy who knows the heartbeat of the Lord.
Sabía el latir del corazón de Dios.
So he kind of dismissed that.
Así que él, ignoró esto.
Then service was almost over.
Y el servicio estaba por terminar.
And that boy came up to this preacher.
Y este joven vino al predicador.
With his head down.
Con su cabeza hacia abajo.
Going like this.
Haciendo así.
Brother.
Le dijo, hermano.
God told me.
Dios me ha dicho.
That I gotta pray for you.
Que ore por ti.
You know that preacher was like, no, sir.
Y ese predicador dijo, no.
God said, if you don't let him pray for you,
y Dios dijo, si tú no me dejas orar por ti,
it's really over.
De verdad que ha terminado.
So he said, okay, come pray for me.
Y le dijo, está bien, ven, ora por mí.
As soon as that boy touched his head,
en el momento que él tocó su cabeza,
the power of the Holy Ghost,
el poder del Espíritu Santo,
began to refill him,
comenzó a llenarlo,
and renew him,
a renovarlo,
and he felt the presence of the Lord. Lord like he had never felt him before. All because a boy would pray, Jesus, I love you most of all. I wonder today, is there anybody here who will pray, Jesus, I love you most of all. I love you more than my job. I love you more than my activities. Amen. I love you more than money. I want everybody to stand for a moment. We need to make that claim here today, right now. Jesus, I love you most of all.
Señor, te amo sobre todas las cosas.
It shouldn't hurt to say it.
No debiera de dolerlo,
it shouldn't be
decirlo.
Something that you're making up.
No es algo que tú te estás inventando.
Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost.
Sí, amen. Hallelujah.
You have other loves.
Tienes otros amores.
Other gods.
Otros dioses.
But I believe God is calling us, the God is calling us today.
Pero Dios nos está llamando hoy.
To confess our love to him.
De confesar nuestro amor hacia él.
Jesus, I love you most of all. I love you more than my situation.
Te amo más que mi situación.
I love you more than my sickness.
Más que mi enfermedad.
I love you more than my need.
Más que mi necesidad.
I love you more than my addiction.
Más que mi adicción.
Jesus, I love you most of all.
Te amo sobre
come
todas
on,
cosas.
Somebody.
Vamos,
you've got to tell the Lord today.
Tienes que decirle eso al Señor.
Saying until you start to feel something. I love you. I love you, Jesus. I love you because you love me first. You loved me when I was unlovable.
Tú me amaste cuando nada me amaba a mí. Hallelujah, Jesús.
I'm telling you right now, church. We need to confess our love to the Lord Jesus Christ. It doesn't matter what your situation is.
No importa cuál sea tu situación.
I know you're saying that's easier said than done, Pastor.
Es fácil decirlo que hacerlo.
You don't know what I'm going through.
No sabes lo que yo estoy atravesando.
You don't know the pain that I'm feeling right
no sabes
now.
El dolor que yo tengo.
You don't know the loneliness.
La soledad que yo siento.
You don't know the darkness in my life.
Tú no sabes la oscuridad en mi vida.
You don't know the depression in my life.
La depresión que yo tengo.
He does. He knows it all. He knew you before you were born.
Él te conoció desde antes que tú nacieras.
He loved you first.
Él te amó primero.
He loved you way before you even knew who he was.
Él te amó desde antes que tú supieras quién era.
Tell God every day.
Necesitas de Dios cada día.
I love you.
Te amo, Señor.
I love you, Jesus.
Te amo, Señor.
I love you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Just worship the Lord.
Gloria a Dios.
I love you, Jesus. Oh, you're so good to me.
Eres tan bueno conmigo, Señor.
Your mercy and your grace endureth forever.
Misericordia y tu gracia es para siempre.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Sea bendecido el nombre del Señor en esta hora.
I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Thank you for Calvary. You could have turned away from the cross, but you didn't. You went through pain first. You suffered first. I'm telling you, saints, every lash, every whip,
cada golpe o cada latigazo,
I love you. Every time he took that whip, He was saying to you today, I love you. Every step on his way to Calvary, while he was carrying that cross, every step was, I love you.
Cada paso decía, te amo.
I love you. Even though there weren't many at the cross. You see, the crowd got thinner and thinner the closer we get to the cross. Jesus was saying, I love you to everyone. Even those who weren't there. We have to appreciate that He loved us first. He gave His life. I know we preach this on Easter. But I'm feeling it today. I never get tired of a story. Of the cross. Because it was for me.
Era para mí.
It was God confessing His love.
Era Dios confesando su amor.
To each and every one of us.
A cada uno de nosotros.
He was saying, I love you.
Te decía, te amo.
When they put the nails in His hand.
Cuando pusieron los clavos en sus manos.
I love you.
Te amo.
When they put the nails through His feet.
Cuando pusieron los clavos en sus pies.
I love you. He said it, He meant it. He backed up His love for you with His actions.
Él mostró su amor con sus acciones.
I'm asking the church today.
Estoy pidiendo a la iglesia hoy en día.
Show God you love
Him. Muéstrele a Dios que tú le amas.
Amen. Let's pray and we're going to dismiss. God help me to appreciate it. Your sacrifice, your unconditional love for me, your love that never grows weak, your love that will never disappear. I thank you for that love that you have for me, God. And I confess, I love you. Ashamed of my love for Jesus. I'm not ashamed. You weren't ashamed of me when I was unlovable. You weren't ashamed of me, Jesus, when I had a foul mouth, when I was hateful, when I was angry, when I was in sin. You weren't ashamed of me. I'm not ashamed of you, Jesus. Today, everything in everything you say, everywhere you go, confess your love for Jesus. Let your words,
deja que tus palabras,
let your actions,
deja que tus acciones,
let your attitude,
que tu actitud,
bring glory to God.
Traiga gloria al Señor.
Jesus' name, you're
dismissed.